Hello automators, thanks for tuning in again. I'm going to show you today how to create basically an infinite loop with your Google Home products. Now you are going to require at least two Google Home or Google Assistant enabled products, but after that, let's have some fun. The use case for this that I'm showing you today is not the most impressive thing, but what I'll tell you is that you can now utilize this and something like If This Then That, which we'll talk about in future videos, to do a lot more interesting things with this infinite loop. We're going to start in the Google Home application, and actually that's all you're going to need as we go through this. Now, on your Google Home application, there is a routines button that you can now click on. And if you scroll all the way to the bottom of your list of routines, you'll find that button, manage routines. Now we're going to open up a new routine by clicking on the plus. And then from there, we're going to hit add commands. And this is what you're going to trigger the entire loop off of. So go ahead and pick whatever you'd like. What I'll tell you is that sometimes you'll want to play with this word because ending it with a B, for example, just doesn't seem to enunciate well out of the Google Assistant. So I called mine blink, and that seems to work fairly well. Now, what we're always going to start any of these routines with is setting the volume to whatever you think is best. And you might have to play with this a little bit. I found 70% worked very well with a Google Home Hub, whereas 50% worked really well with a Google Home Mini. So it does help if you have the same two devices sitting next to each other. Now, for my demo, I'm going to just simply turn on a light with the first part of my routine set here, and that's all we're going to have to do other than say something immediately after that. And what we're going to say is the wake word for another Google product and then the name of the second routine. But I'm not going to put that in this first one because it helps to add a delay with Google Home products. So now that I have the wake word written in there, I just simply hit back, and then I make sure there's check marks on the two actions I want to add to my routine, and then I hit the add button up in the top right. So what we have now is setting the volume to 70%, adjusting our light and our plug, and then we say something. And if I wanted to, I could rearrange the order of these things, but that is the order that you're going to want. So you can see on the right, there are the double lines, and those I can just grab and drag actions up and down to reorder them as I'd like to. We're going to again add another action, and this is in the popular actions, and now I'm going to actually type in my exact name of the second routine. So we're going to create two separate routines here. So that's important to keep in mind. In order to execute this loop, you need at least two. You could make three or four or five if you'd like, and just make sure that each one references the next one. So now we have four commands here in our new routine called blank. And what we're doing is setting the volume to 70%, adjusting our light, our plug, or doing whatever we want to do within this part of the routine or the infinite loop. And then we use the wake word. And then in a separate say something, we use the name of this next routine in the series. Once we've done all that, we hit the check mark up in the top right, and that creates our new custom routine. Now we're going to create a second, and this is the name of your second routine, or the thing you just referenced in the first routine. So again, I had put in no blank as the name of the second routine, and that's what my Google Home product or Google Assistant is saying. And now we're really going to follow the same process. So we're going to set the volume on this device. Once we've added that, we're going to add a second action, which is choosing popular actions. I'm going to adjust that light or plug or do whatever I want to do in this second part of our loop. And you can see I'm just turning off one light. And then I'm scrolling down to the bottom and I'm going to say something, which is, again, the wake word for our Google Assistant. Now, finally, we're going to add another say something component here. So another action, and then choosing popular actions, and then we're going to say something. And this is going to go to our next part of the loop. But in this case, it's just the first name. So because I only have a two-part infinite loop, I'm saying the name of the first routine. Now, I'm all done. I have those same four steps, and the only difference here is that the last thing I say is that custom routine named blank, and here's my other one called no blank. So that's it, guys. So that's the entire process. We're going to show you, of course, how this works, and you can go ahead and expand this with multiple parts of the routine. Obviously, you're going to hear your Google Assistant, so this works better to start and then walk away from and leave the speaker sitting in a room next to each other.
No blink. Blink. No blink. Link.
All right, guys, now down below, what you're seeing is links to other videos that I've done related to routines. And you can see Google integration with Amazon Echo, and you can see an additional set of routines videos that will help you out here. And I'm going to be producing more of these as we go forward. So look for those, join us on Automate Your Life, hit that subscribe button, and we'll see you next time.